Hi, welcome to the very first video in the series of installing Odoo on your local system and configuring it with Pycharm so that you can program easily and you can debug easily. I'm your host Taha. I am co-founder and CEO at Jilani Consultancy and Solutions. We create websites, web applications, Android applications, and so on. If you have any difficulty in installation, you can get in touch with me on my email, or you can just fill up the contact us form on our website. So let's get started. I have taken some inspiration from Cybrosys blog for some basic steps. Though I followed majority of those steps, but initially when I tried installing and my teams tried installing, we got bumped into a lot of hurdles. So I thought we'll just make a video wherein we can explain you the whole process. Okay, to get started, first of all, let's launch the command prompt. All right, and then run this sudo apt-get update and upgrade. Okay, so it asks for the password, fill in the password. It just runs these updates. We'll just wait for these updates to complete. Welcome back. Now, if you see my command line, this we are done with the upgrade and update. Now we'll proceed to the next step, which is we install all the dependencies that are present. So I have already installed this, but I'll once again hit this command. If you haven't installed it, you'll have to install this. So all these commands you'll be finding in the description of the video. The third step is installing Pycharm. So let's install Pycharm. All right, so I'll go to Software Center, Ubuntu Software Center. Okay, there are multiple ways of installing this. You can either install it from their website. You can download and unzip it and install it from the website, or you can just search over here as Pycharm. So here you see all the editions of Pycharm. I have installed Pycharm Pro. For the tutorial purpose, I'll install Pycharm Community Edition as well. Okay, so authenticate. So once again, depending upon your internet speed as well as your computer, this might take some time. I'll just pause the video till the installation completes. Okay, so now you can see that Pycharm is installed. Just to check, I'll just launch it. So you just select on do not import anything and I confirm, and you can select any of the themes that you like, then you can start using Pycharm. Okay, so this will open up the Pycharm and it will ask you to create a new project. As of now, I'm happy that it is installed. I'll just close this and proceed for my next step. Okay, so the next step is install PostgreSQL. Once again, I have installed this. Okay, so you can, if you haven't installed it, you can copy this command to just upgrade the package list once. Okay, and you can install PostgreSQL by typing this command. Okay, we'll just wait for this to complete. I'll once again pause the video so that the video is not too bulky. Now we'll install PostgreSQL. Since it's already installed on my system, so it will just show like this. For you, it will just grab it from this one and install it. Next part is to setting up PostgreSQL. For this, we type this command. Okay, So it will log in as Postgres user, okay, and then we'll create a DB and it will ask password, enter a password. Okay, so okay. So for me, it is showing that creation of new role failed, error role Odoo already exists. The reason being, I've already done this step and I don't want to confuse you by making this Odoo 1 or Odoo 2, etc. If I do that, it will accept once again. Okay, so now we'll proceed to logging in. Okay, NPS 12. So now it is a Postgres command prompt. From Ubuntu command prompt, we are now into Postgres. Okay, so first step they say is to change the user to the super user by typing this command. Okay, I copy and paste it. Next, we need to quit from Postgres. That we do by typing slash q, and then we even exit from the Postgres. You can see that earlier I was logged in as Gilani1 and now I'm logged in as Postgres. So I need to once again shift back to my previous login. So we are done with step number 5. Now the next step is cloning the Odoo from GitHub. Okay, so we'll copy this and we'll come once again to our home directory. I'm currently in the home directory. In whichever directory, make sure that you want the Odoo to be, make sure that you are into that directory and then you type this command. Okay, so once again, based upon your internet speed, this will take some time. I'll pause the video till this is done. Okay, as you can see, the repository is cloned on my local system. Okay, so the next part will be, I'll just open it on my local system and I'll just show you the files that are there. So if I go into Odoo, so all these files are cloned from that GitHub repository. Okay, just note down that here there is one file called requirements.txt. okay, we'll just come to that in a while. Okay, so this file that we just saw, requirements.txt, it has all the components, Python libraries, etc., that are required for Odoo to run smoothly. Okay, so now what we do next is we install the Odoo requirements. So Odoo requirements can be installed by typing this command, pip3 install requirements.txt. okay, so I'll type that command. Okay, so it says that could not open requires.txt because I am not in the directory. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll go into the directory and I'll see whether requirements.txt file is there. Yes, that is there. Next, I'll type pip3 install requirements.txt. Okay, so one by one it will gather all the requirements and install it. I'll pause the video till these requirements are installed. So if you see here, all these requirements that are there for Odoo to run smoothly are almost done. Okay, now we'll proceed to next step, that is creating a config file. So if you see now, all the dependencies are done. Okay, so our next step is to create a config file. I have one sample odoo.conf that I'll provide you in the download section. So here, first one, you can see that there are many options in here. I won't be going in details of each and every one. I'll just explain the ones that are important. So you can see that on add-ons underscore path, we list all the add-ons folder where you can where you will be storing your add-ons. And then there is admin password. Keep this something strong. Then there's another DB password. I have kept it as a password for simplicity. You are advised to keep it something strong. Okay, I'll pause the video and start the next part in the next session. Okay, welcome back. Here, I'll come back to the configuration file. I just as explained previously, there are other configurations as well mentioned over here. Now, this looks okay to me. There's one more setting called DB user. We have configured it as Odoo. If you have configured it as something else, keep that. All right. Now, next step is we need to open PyCharm and open this project in PyCharm and then try to run it. All right. So let me launch PyCharm. Okay. So I'll start PyCharm Community Edition. I'll click on open. I'll browse to the Odoo project. I'll click on OK. Now it will load the entire project for me. Okay. Now we can see that these play button or run command is not visible to me. We'll wait for it to scan the indexes. This takes a couple of seconds to complete. I'll better pause the video till the indexing completes. Okay, so welcome back. So if I see here that my indexing is complete, but I still don't see this play button or run button come over here. I see that there is one button called add configuration. Okay, so we'll just click on add configuration. There's a plus icon over here. I'll click on that icon. I'll click on Python. So this path comes up. Okay, so script path is something which you will be clicking here and pointing to Odoo bin. So remember that this is the GitHub folder that you downloaded. This is the same project which we imported over here. Okay, and here you'll have to search for Odoo bin. It is over here. I select it. Okay. And then next part is the parameters. So when the Odoo bin runs, when this Python project runs, what are the additional parameters we are providing? Currently, we are just providing it. We are telling that take the configurations from odoo.conf files. Okay. So where is this odoo.conf file? This is the same file which we just created over here. So what I'll do is I can copy paste it in the same folder. Okay. Now I'll come back once again to the PyCharm. Okay, we have let this be as it is. Now the third part is the Python interpreter. Usually sometimes this takes Python interpreter as some virtual environment or from virtual environment or from somewhere else. Make sure that your Python interpreter is 3.6, 3.5, etc. and not 2.7 or some it has not picked up from virtual environment. Why this is important is when you have installed the dependency in your first step, like here various dependencies you have installed, and then you have installed these requirements.txt, various requirements that are there. These requirements are like py to pdf or generating pdf, etc. Those are all installed for your Python 3.6 or your desired Python. So if this is not selected properly, those modules will not be detected. Okay, those Python modules or libraries won't be detected. Okay, so working directory is this, rest of all the things looks fine. Just click on apply and click on OK. Now once this is done, we'll run this project. Okay, so you get an error that Odoo bin, the config file odoo.conf doesn't exist or is not readable. Okay, the reason is that if you come over here, there's no odoo.conf file over here. What I'll do is I have this file on my desktop. I'll copy and paste it over here. Okay, and I'll run this once again. Now once again I'm getting some error. It says that couldn't load module web, no module web, and so on. Okay, so this is because the if you read these errors, the first error is saying that add-on path. So these add-on paths are not present on my system currently. Okay, so that is the reason I'm getting these errors. Okay, so I'll just explain. You see, the add-on's correct path is this. Okay, so if I this slash home slash glanimal slash odoo slash add-ons is the correct path of the add-on and not something which is mentioned over here. So what I'll be doing is I'll be just removing those additional paths from my conf file. Okay, and I'll put these add-ons path over there instead of current add-on path. Okay, so I'll click on editing this file. I'll remove all these additional paths and I'll just put the current path. Suppose if you are doing some custom add-on developments and you have created another folder for your custom add-ons, you can add a comma in front of this and add it. We'll see that shortly. Okay, after that I'll stop this. Okay, and I'll run it again. So now it has detected all the add-ons properly and it is saying that running on Gilani Inspiron 3537 on port number 8069. I'll just copy this path, all right, and then I'll go to Chrome and I'll paste this. Okay, so now I see an error saying error empty response. Okay, so everything is working fine, but we still get this. This is because there are some permission issues that are happening and we are not able to get a proper response through the script. To overcome this, we need to run PyCharm as a sudo user, that is as a super user we need to run. So what we'll do is, whatever we have done now, we'll just quickly repeat it by exiting PyCharm and running PyCharm as super user. Okay, so we'll open this command sudo. If you type PyCharm, so we were in PyCharm community edition, so I'll click on sudo PyCharm community. Okay, it will ask me for the password. I'll enter the password. So it says previous version is over there. I'll just say do not import anything. Okay, I confirm as if you have a choice. Then I'll select any of the screen. I'll start using PyCharm. Okay, now once again I'll browse to the folder where I have cloned Odoo. Okay, so that is in my home folder. Okay, under Odoo. Okay, so if you see here, all these configurations are set already for this because we had previously set it. Suppose if it is not set, just set it the same way as we explained in the last video. Okay, so it will once again index. Till the time it index, I'll pause this video. Okay, if you see now, we are done with indexing and I see that Odoo bin over is over here. I'll just edit configuration to make sure all the things are set as I have set, but I can see that Python interpreter, no interpreter is set over here. Okay, so if no interpreter is set over here, we'll have to do some changes. All right, so to do that, press Ctrl Alt S. Okay, that will open the settings window. Over here, go into the project Odoo. This may vary based upon what you have selected. Then select on project interpreter. Okay, click on this setting icon and click on add. All right, so here there is a base interpreter is selected. Go to system interpreter. This is selected as user slash bin slash. Click on OK. Click on apply. Click on OK. All right, so once this is done, we'll once again go to edit configurations. So let it complete these processes, then we'll be able to edit the configurations. So this will take a while, as in, you know, once you have changed it, it is indexing the files once again. So once they are done, I'll once again go to edit configuration. We can see that the Python interpreter, the one we want, is selected over there. We click on OK. And once again, we press this play button. Okay, just to repeat what we have done is, in the edit configuration, we did not see the right version of the Python, or no Python interpreter was selected. So we quickly press Ctrl Alt S, and we press Ctrl Alt S, and this setting thing came up. Here we went to project, under project we came to interpreter, and here we selected Python 3.6. All right, now let's press the run button. So it says that running as a root is user is a security risk. There are other ways to work around this, as in by running every command as a sudo users and so on, but this one is simpler, so we have chosen this one. So now if you visit this URL once again, which was giving us an empty response, you'll see this. What I'll do is, I'll just select, instead of that long URL, you can even, you know, this is my machine's name actually, that is the reason it has come. So from machine to machine, this will vary. So the safe option is, you just press localhost colon 8069. Okay, so this loads. Next, you can manage the database, you can create new database, and so on as per your requirements. Okay, now we'll see how do we create, how do we add a breakpoint and run the debug mode. Okay, for that, first what we'll do is, we'll just open a file, which is Odoo's file. Okay, so let's go to init.py itself. Okay, and then add a breakpoint somewhere. I'll stop this and I'll run it as in the debug mode. You're seeing this bug. So as soon as I run it in the debug mode, you can see that it is stuck over here. So if there are some variables that are there, you can check the values of those variables as well over here. Okay, so that completes our video about installation of Odoo and linking it with PyCharm. Not exactly installation of Odoo, it is more like running Odoo through PyCharm so that you can be more productive in your development. So to recap, what we have done is, in the first step, we installed the Python dependencies, then we installed PyCharm. After that, we installed PostgreSQL and added a user Odoo. All right, then we cloned the repository. We installed the requirements that were there for Odoo. After that, we created a configuration file, and then we configured PyCharm. We encountered a hiccup when we did not run PyCharm as a root user. We overcome by running Python as root user. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please let me know your thoughts, your queries, etc. in the comment section, and we'll try to respond back to you. Once again, we are from Jilani Consultancy and Solutions. We create websites, web applications, and Android application. Please feel free to contact us if you have any requirements. Thank you.